Yes, those thunderstorm chances, at least feared for the metro, they actually have a better chance of occurring late tonight and overnight, even Friday late day through the evening period and really across the entire viewing area. Yes, that flood threat not only continues, but continues to increase. Let's do this. Let's bring in a live look at how things are shaping up with our severe weather outlook. And anywhere within this yellow has a chance for some strong to severe thunderstorm activity. Now, for the morning hours, the bigger focus for thunderstorms will be across extreme southeast Nebraska into portions of Kansas. But as we go into the later periods of tonight and overnight, certainly could see some stronger or severe thunderstorms start to set up. Notice the majority of the heaviest rain is literally just west and south of the Omaha metro. Now, as we make our way down towards areas south the Grand Island around Beatrice as well. We'll bring the picture out and you can see kind of how this whole entire system is moving off towards the southeast. Earlier around the West Point and Hooper area, we did have a little isolated shower develop, and still, if more showers are able to develop north of I-80, they'll be very isolated, very hit or miss in nature, and very short-lived. The main cluster of rain is going to set up south of I-80, affecting southeast Nebraska, especially into eastern Kansas and maybe clipping portions of northwestern Missouri. You get back into southwestern Iowa, and I just don't think there's that good of a significant rain chance for the morning hours. Really, it's kind of hugging more so southeast Nebraska into eastern portions of Kansas. Temperatures right now look like this: 66 Valley, 64 Gretna. On the way to a warm day, temperatures back into the mid-80s for daytime highs. A little bit cooler north of the metro towards Tecama, Harlan, up towards Carroll as well. 54 degrees currently in Denison. 63 right now at the Omaha Epley Airport, 54 degrees. That's the current dew point. Not a tremendous amount of moisture to work with right now, with winds staying calm. Here's Storm Predictor, and here's how things are looking. This cluster of storms sliding off towards the southeast as we go throughout the morning hours. Maybe some back development across southeastern Nebraska around the noon hour, but still the heaviest rain setting up for the morning and then trying to diminish somewhat. By 5 p.m., partly sunny skies. There'll be a frontal system off towards our south, and as it lifts north later tonight, well, that'll be our thunderstorm chance. Once again, Storm Predictor showing temperatures warmest as we go down towards Salina. Hayes, 87 Hastings, with temperatures basically in the mid-80s as we go throughout eastern Nebraska, western Iowa for today. Let's talk about the overnight period. The showers and thunderstorms scattered in nature around the area all the way through 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. Could see a shower or a thunderstorm starting the day off on Friday morning. Otherwise, as we make our way towards, let's go ahead and say Friday late day, into the nighttime hours as well, that's when we have an increasing chance yet again of more scattered showers and thunderstorms, quite possibly holding on to early Saturday morning. So something to keep in mind for the activity setting up at TD Ameritrade Park tomorrow evening. Now, as we continue through about the 8 a.m. hour as we go towards Friday, notice yet again our model run trying to back down the precipitation around the metro, keeping things the heaviest off towards the south. Again, it's Falls City back towards Beatrice, where we will see the heaviest rain. But again, that's Friday morning. All areas, though, across the KETV viewing area looking at the chance for some shower and thunderstorm activity. 10 a.m. though, I think partly sunny, maybe a few more clouds than what you're seeing right here in the metro. Rain shower chances better off towards the south. Otherwise, by 4 o'clock, 85 degrees, partly sunny, southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour. And looking ahead towards 9 p.m. mostly cloudy skies, storms west and south of the Omaha metro. Here's how things look as we go towards Friday. Morning showers a possibility, otherwise showers and thunderstorms possibly redeveloping in the afternoon and evening. Saturday looks like this, a chance for a morning shower, but I think the games on Saturday and Sunday for the CWS should be in good shape. Nicole?